Eivor, I'm pleased you came. Welcome to my estate, old friend.
Thane Elfgard. It's an impressive amount of land you oversee.
Quite right. I often get lost swimming to my island in this flowing sea of wheat.
You're flush with land and crops, to be sure. You're a brave man to flaunt your riches from this lonely hill.
It's not bravery, it's trust. I trust the respect I've earned keeps Saxon and Dane alike from temptation.
You said you had something to show me when we last spoke. What did you mean?
Yes, I did. Observe. This fine specimen belonged to our beloved elderman, Hunbeort, before his untimely passing. He left it here when we last hunted together. I now wish you to have it.
This has the feeling of a bribe, Elfgard. Are you trying to win my favor for some reason?
Bribe you? Heavens no. This is a simple gift of thanks for solving the mystery of Hunbeort's disappearance. Now, take it and come hither. I have a rousing hunt planned for the two of us. Leave aside talk of politics and shire moats. Let us enjoy the fruits of my land together.
We're hunting or fruit picking?
Both, if you like. Whatever you fancy. I'm generous with the yields of my estate, as you will see. To be plain, Eivor, a great bear has been badgering my estate for weeks. I must do away with it, if only to prevent a future tragedy.
You brought me here to hunt a bear?
Yes, and I'm so pleased you agreed to come. I suspect you know better than most that I have what it takes to lead this shire. Though its line of kings is all but ended, the people of this land still teems with life, with promise. But today, the shire languishes. It needs the guidance of new blood.
Like me.
I'm sorry?
I'm the definition of new blood. It may be I should put my name in for Elderman.
Ah, there it is, that dark sense of humor. Blunt as a hammer, eh? Like the one carried by your thunder god. I don't recall the name.
Go on.
What I mean to say is, I enjoy the company of your people. Or people like you. What little I've seen of them. And I don't care what stuffy fools like Herifriv and Hunwald say. You Danes are damned decent people. Not dense at all.
Kind of you to notice.
I remember when the Danes first arrived, not long ago. The local...
Are we hunting, Elfgard? Or is it your hope that I'll braid your hair?
Hunting, definitely! The bear's lair should be nearby. My old friend Grimm. How wonderful to see you here. What a pleasant surprise.
What surprise? I came as you requested.
Yes, and how is Grimsby? How are all the other Danes?
I can't speak for all Danes, But I am well, and itching for a hunt, as you made plain in your message this morning.
Yes, that's right. Very good. Speaking of Danes, I'd like to introduce you to Eivor. Perhaps you know each other as one Dane to another.
Don't be frightened, Grim, but I believe Alfgard has arranged for us to meet.
Oh, goodness, I've been discovered. But it's nothing untoward, I promise. I'm an honest man, and I believe that all people should live together in harmony. That's all.
Hey, Eivor. Did he lure you here as well with the promise of a hunt?
He...
Yes, hunting a bear. That's the point of all this. We're hunting, I promise.
There's a cave just up the hill there. Seems a likely place for a lair.
If the beast is as large as Alfgard claims, it'll take all three of us to bring it down.
I'm game. Let's get a new fur cloak, shall we? There's all manner of beasts in this forest. If we don't find the bear, we'll find something worth our supper.
I have a divine rule over the land on my estate. God shall provide. Have no worry.
This is the threshold of a beast's home. There's no doubting that. That's not a bear. What's that? Wolves.
Like a twig!
Soon to be a sea of fire.
Eivor! You're skilled enough, and I can't tell you how to handle this, but... Please! My God, help me with this!
I'm in this fight with you! A clutch of puny Mercians don't frighten me!
People are fleeing! They must get...
Best not to draw attention.
Until you were away.
Where's Alfgard, bloody Dane?
Burn this Dane lover down!
Thank you.
men who would see you burn are dead. Let's get these fires out.
Agreed.
What a mess. A sea of ashes. I thank you, Eivor, for doing what you could.
You're a man of many riches, Alfgar. You can rebuild.
To be sure. But I do not look forward to the toilet. Sweet Lord in heaven! The bear is returned!
The Shiremut will start soon. I should return to Lincoln to see that it goes well.
There, you see? Didn't I promise you a rousing hunt? Brilliant! Simply brilliant!
Archer, is everything ready?
The Shiremut will soon begin. Will you join us, Eivor? We'd be comforted by your presence.
Yes, I'm curious to see this Shiremut for myself. I'll follow. When will the boat begin, Abbas?
12 able lords of Lincolnshire have already cast their stones, but they have reached a tie. 4 votes for each man. It now falls to you to break this impasse.
Me? By whose order?
You have earned the trust of our 3 candidates, it seems. Even our bishop has found a certain fondness for your hardy spirit.
It's an important vote for your people. How would you counsel my vote?
I value competent and righteous leadership, not foolish friends in high seats.
Anyone but Hunwald, you mean?
I love Hunwald, as I love my own kin. but I would not put a stone in his care without fearing for the safety of both. I pray that God guides your vote today, and not the devil, as I fear.
How are you, Lord?
Have I heard aright that you have come to break us from our deadlock?
I have, Lord.
Lord Hundbeor was a bold. I see the same qualities in his son.
King Ceolwulf's attendant, aren't you?
Aye. The king sends his love and support. Whatever happens here today.
He's learning fast. Good evening, Alfgard.
Eivor, I hope it's not untoward of me to solicit, but I do need it. The vote...
It's a difficult choice, Alfgard.
Good, good. But let me say, unreserved...
I don't doubt your conviction. Grim, good to see you again.
A hearty hello, Drengir. Seems Britain is getting quite used to the idea of Danes stalking.
Where do you fall in this contest, Grim? Elfgard is a friend of yours.
He is. And a good man as well. But I cast my stone.
The bishop?
These Christians are easy to nudge about. So desperate they are to avoid a good...
A vote for Hunwald will return the House of the Ferocious Swan to it.
How fare you, Lord?
My prayers are fervent and my will is strong, Eivor. If I am Elderman, I will bring joy to this Shire.
There's more to good leadership than merrymaking. You must be strong and stern and willing to take risks.
Of course, of course. Strength and wisdom and fortitude and all that. I shall rise above the peat moss of mediocrity. Have no fear.
That's good to hear.
A vote for Hunwald will return the House of the Ferocious Swan to its former glory.
Bishop,
Eivor, I must thank you for your fearless participation in our moot.
I'm surprised to hear.
I surprised myself, to be honest. Under my guidance, this Shire. God knows the love that lives in my heart for the people of Lincolnshire.
Quite a gambit, Bishop.
Well then, I thank you for what...
Three men, three possible futures.
Which of these sad puppets will dance best when you call upon them?
It's not for myself I must cast this stone, but for my clan. Who will serve us best in a time of true need?
You can never be certain where you stand in another's heart. Choose only for yourself.
All three have strengths and weaknesses. Though tinged with arrogance, Alfgar is competent and wealthy. He'd be a good Elderman, but a faithful ally? Hunwald is not the most cunning or clever, but he has heart and spirit. Both go a long way in times of need. The bishop can be stuffy and wallows in Christian piety. But he is wisest of the three, and has already proven himself. Though tinged, I choose Alfgar. He is sturdy and competent, and his wealth will be a boon.
It is decided. By the grace of God, the new Elderman is Lord Algar of Lincoln.
God has spoken, and his voice is a clarion call. As your Elderman, I will work to better this Shire, to foster peace between its people, and to serve our king. I bless you all.
Let us all raise our cups. A toast to our new Elderman. As all well know, this Shiremute's decision is not final, but advisory. It now falls to our newly anointed King Ceolwulf to ratify our choice. To this end, we need not worry. Ceolwulf is a friend to Saxon and Dane alike, and he is sure to approve the results. Our good and noble friend, Arthelswith.
A septic rot has overtaken this Shire. A sickness for which there is only one cure.
Your Grace! What is this?
Nobles of Lincolnshire, stand fast!
For the glory of the ancients, leave none alive!
Steal your sword! Mother of God! Another battle!
Your troubles begin early, Alfgar.
We'll find and kill that man.
To think such carnage could happen in Lincoln.
The The grief Tassakan have gone far. Race afeared and march against what men he has left.
Agreed. Hunwald, will you fight with me?
Sweep me!
I will. For the sake of Lincolnshire, I bloody will.
I am at a loss for words. A trusted man of the cloth. I will pray for these martyrs, and tend to the remaining wounded until the last man walks free.
Be well, Archer.
And you, Eivor. May God or the gods protect you.
Such carnage I've never seen! That twisted bishop must pay the devil his due.
What news?
We have learned that Herefrith occupies a fort at Anacastra, south of here. An eager fear awaits my voice to lead him into battle. Will you ride with us?
I've gone some days without a proper siege. Lead on.
To the camp, then, and onward to Anacastra. Follow, if you will.
Herefrith was a friend of my father's and always so dear to me. I don't understand what possessed him.
He invoked the name of an ancient order before his men attacked. I know exactly what possessed him.
Do you?
It's not a story for now.
This will send waves of disgust through all the parishes of Mercia. Herefrith is a new and ugly stain on the bishopric.
Your Christ was an interesting man, if a little soft. But stranger still, I've met so few Christians like him.
Today has been a boon, Eivor. In spite of everything, I now know my father's spirit still burns within me. It's thanks to you I know this. When songs are sung of the day Lincolnshire was saved, your name will ripple through every stanza.
Don't be hasty, Hunwald. One verse of our song remains unsung. The din of battle beckons.
You pagans and your appetite for battle. I certainly don't share it. I worry what diabolical feast the bishop has in store.
Don't let that poxy bishop worry you. With Eivor beside us, he'll be victuals before long. How has Archer taken all this? She and Herefrith were so close.
She must feel as though the devil himself attacked her monastery. The poor lady.
We spoke briefly. Her spirits were low, but her work carried on. I think she'll be fine.
Manipulated by a man who should be God's gladdener.
Our camp is just here.
Who's fetching the turf this time, eh? Don't want to freeze to death here.
Metaphrines will entrench deeper with every passing hour.
Our warsmith has arrived. The Feards are ready to fight.
Chieftain Eivor, can we win this battle with a small number you see assembled here?
If they fight as strongly as they smell, we'll claim victory.
Then we'll have no cause for worry. We should attack soon, before the bishop can muster more troops. What do you think, Eivor?
We attack now. Ready the Feard.
Our first task will be to breach the outer wall. Then we deal with the troops inside.
The best way to breach is with a battering ram. I should help it along.
Thank you.
Elgar! Point me to the bishop. No one else need die today.
He's in the chapel there, hiding away. Scabrous coward.
Let no one leave that church without facing judgment.
Thomas and Finney saw up to move. I'm his Finney.
The other side must be barred. Locked from the other side.
I died the day I hid behind these robes, this cross. To bring the light of my order to a wider view, I did baste myself. Clawed my way to the top of this common religion, full of common men. I should have lived as the ancients did.
That's the folly of mankind, Hiravrid. We wallow in our failures like happy pigs in a sty of shit. We should have learned to enjoy it.
told you.
Eivor! You fought as one possessed by a demon today.
Herefrid may yet have allies in Mercia, members of his secret order, but the immediate danger is past.
You have my deepest thanks, Eivor. To you I owe all my future happiness and prosperity.
You're a good fit for Eldamon, Elfgard. Just make sure you put the Shire's needs above your own.
Of course. I'd not be the man I am today without this land, these people.
It's a shame Hunwald was not fit to don his father's boots, but he can bring joy to the people here. Treat him well.
Yes, about that. I believe he has a somewhat different idea of his future. You should talk to him.
About?
Until next we meet, Eivor. The strength of Lincolnshire is yours, should you need it.
We are bonded now. Your people and mine.
I have found better friends in Danes, to be honest. Swanborough is my love, and you are a better friend to me than any here. Would it be an imposition to ask... Well, could we live with your clan? Swanborough and I. It would mean so much to her. And to me.
Of course you may. We'd be happy to host you, ferocious swan, and your charming dame. Come when it suits you.
Oh, yes! I'll pull my weight, I promise. And fight when needs be, and I won't drink more than I'm allotted.
You fight with us, Hunwald, and you can drink as much as you like.
Thank you, Eivor. This means... It means the world to me.
Now it seems the wind calls me back to Randvi. Let's tell her the good news.
Lincolnshire is a friend to us.
Wonderful news.
Alfgar is now Ealdorman of Lincolnshire. I believe...
Good. I hope...